Hello everyone, welcome back, and this is the final video in this series. And in this video, we're just gonna add some props, make our level look a little bit more interesting than it already does, as it's coming along pretty well. Our door is working again, and we're getting some nice lighting in here, and there's a lot of pillars. So I think it's looking pretty good. Let's add some props to kind of decorate it a little bit. In this back section here, we had this temporary light that we were using. I'm gonna actually delete that, because we're going to add some better lights here and make some adjustments to those. So it got dark in here, but we're going to add some new lights. So let's go. We are already in the props folder. There's a bunch of stuff in here. So let's drag some stuff in. Let's drag in a table, because every office needs a table. And let's drag in some chairs. Here's a chair. Just going to drag that in. Compress E to go to rotate mode and just rotate it like so. And let's actually... this brings up an interesting thing. Might as well show this since we're here. We are currently, this kind of gets into the introduction series. We skipped over that and went straight to this level editing. This is a handy little tool for you. We are currently moving our object in world space. So as I move this object along the floor here, I am currently moving it in world space. So I'm moving right now along the Y, and now I'm moving it along the X. But what if I wanted to move it towards the table like I just wanted to do? We can change to local space for our particular chair here. So if I hold Control and tap the tilde key, which is next to the 1 key, if I tap that, you can see our move tool changes. Now if I drag along the X, I can now slide it into that table. And that's nice. That's exactly what I wanted. So I'm going to hit Control tilde again to get back into world space. You can also click the globe icon up here to get to that as well. So if I click it, can see the move tool changing. So now we have that there. Let's go ahead and just alt drag this over and press E to go into rotation mode and rotate it around. They're sitting at the table like that. I guess we could add two more along the back. So let's control select both of those. Hold alt. Well, let's get to move tool first by pressing W. Hold alt to drag those over. Press E to go to rotation mode. Rotate those around so they're not in the wall, and press, let's rotate them a little bit more, W, and move them over and slide them into place something like that, so that there's four nice little tables sitting around, or nice little chairs sitting around this table. Something like that. That is good enough, but it is awfully dark in here, so let's actually go to the blueprints folder. And if we go to blueprints inside the starter content, you can see that there's a couple stuff in here already ready for us to make use of, like this blueprint ceiling light. So that looks good. Let's just drag that in. And we'll place it right in the center of our table like that and let it go. Then I'm gonna drag it up into the scene, and look at that. It already has a light attached to it and everything. Nice, very nice. I'm gonna drag that into the ceiling. And inside the details panel for that, because the way this blueprint was set up, we can actually just change the brightness right in here, or we can change the color of it as well. Let's go ahead and make it a nice bluish, color, whitish color like that. That looks good. And let's add a couple more lights actually inside the blueprints folder. There's a blueprint wall sconce. Let's actually drag that in. And let's press W and drag that up. And what you're seeing here are the light rays, or the light radius, the inner and outer cones of this particular type of light. Right now, if I zoom in on it, our light is actually backwards. Another way you can kind of see, if you press G on your keyboard, that will hide all of the editor elements. If we press G again, all of our editor elements are temporarily disabled. By pressing G, it gives us a game view. So you can think of it that way, G for game view. Now you can see that our light here is actually facing the wrong way. So let's press E to go to rotation, and let's just turn it around 180 degrees, and W to move it up against the wall, like so. And it's kind of clipping into the wall. Let's just back it out a little bit more, like so. And that's kind of cool. Let's leave it like that. You can change the color and the settings in the details panel for this if you'd like. For us, we're just gonna leave it like that. I'm gonna hold Alt and drag over a copy, like so. And let's add some on this side too as well. So I'm just gonna hold Alt, drag one over here, and release Alt, and then press Alt again and drag one over here. Looking pretty nice. I like it. So we have that. Let's let's go back to the props folder. And inside the props, we're going to add a statue just for fun, like so. That is a pretty big statue that everyone's sitting around the table looking at. We could scale that. Let's just scale it down to 0.5 all around. There we go. So we have some lighting. We have some tables and chairs. It's looking pretty good. There's one more thing that I want to do. Our tables and chairs, they have this nice, shiny, metallic effect to them. And it's not actually capturing the reflection the way I want. If we go to the visual effects section of the modes panel here, there is a sphere reflection capture. As the tooltip says, used to capture the scene for reflection in a sphere shape. And if we drag this in, you can see it's starting to make an effect. Well, we have to press G first to get out of game view so we can see it. You can see it's kind of making an effect. You won't really get the full effect of it until we rebuild lighting, which we'll do here in a moment. But we're just going to drag one in here and center it up on the table, like so. Something like that. And I'm going to hold Alt and drag another one over here. So we're getting some reflections off our marble floor and our glass. And while we're at it, let's just drag another one here. I'm going to hold Shift while I do it to move the camera with me. And for the heck of it, just break it up into quadrants, move one over here as well, holding Alt and Shift. So there we go. Let's actually go to our build settings here and go to lighting quality, and let's bump up our lighting quality. Let's bump that up to production and then go ahead and click build. It's going to take a little bit longer than it did before because we're going to improve the quality of our lighting here for our level when we build it. And just give that a second to go here. If we had a much bigger level, it would take much longer. But for right now, I think this will be fine. It should only take a second or two more. But I think our level's looking pretty good. I think we can wrap it up here in a second. And there we go. Let's hit G to get into game view. Looking pretty nice. So let's go ahead and play in the editor here. And let me turn my sound down one more time so you don't hear that. Getting some nice shadows, some nice reflection from the sun beaming off our marble floor. Going up to our door here, and it opens. Looking good. Floor looks nice. You know what? There's one more thing that I want to do. I'm going to hit Escape really quickly. I'm going to select all of our chairs here. And this is always fun. And our table and our statue. Inside the Details panel, I'm going to move this over and Simulate Physics. And with that enabled, I'm going to replay inside our editor here. And, well, that didn't want that to happen. They exploded on top of each other. Wanted to be able to just shoot them because that's always fun. Let me actually move them back so they don't pop into the world from by default here. So I'm going to grab the X and the Y here and just going to drag it over a little bit. I think I grabbed all of them. Make sure it's not in the floor. Gonna move it back so that it's not right on top of the table. I think that's why they popped like that. And rotate it a little bit more. And let's move this one back. Let's hop over to local space. Control with tilde. Move that over. Let's do this one too, really quickly. Something like this. And like that. I'm going to rotate this one really quickly because I'm being nitpicky and move them back. Hopefully that should be good. Let's try and play again. Actually, let's try and simulate before we play. So I'm going to click this drop down and simulate. Looking good and like it's not going to do anything funky. And let's select a viewport again. Let's play. And there we go. We can now shoot our tables because I am happy to shoot things. Look at that. What a perfect way to end the video right there. And on that note, I hope you guys enjoyed this video series, and I hope you guys tune into some more video series here for Unreal Engine 4. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much.